In this lesson 4.2, we're going to learn to export the Illustrator file, yeah, to Procreate together with the layers and from pen tool to brush in Procreate. And then we're going to talk about alpha lock, not alpha layer, so it's alpha lock in Procreate. Okay, later I'll change that. And 4, enhance your drawing with the different brushes that found in Procreate. There are many brushes, but we're going to touch on just a couple of them today because we can't cover all, and you will not be able to absorb all. Even myself too, I do not use all. Some artists, they may just use one airbrush. And because when you tap on one brush, there are also many other sub-menu of that brushes, okay? And finally, we're going to paint a panda bear in pop-up style. So the main focus is applying the digital brush here, okay, in Procreate. We're going to touch on airbrush, artistic brush, texture brush, inking brush, and maybe one abstract brush. To fill in the bear, or to paint the bear, with all the different brushes found in Procreate. Alright. Okay, now, shall we move on to Procreate right now? Yes. Oh, sorry. I have to bring up the file. Okay, so we don't need the original, so you can see the hair. So we take it out. We're gonna export this file to Procreate with all the layers, and later I'll tell you the reason why it's important. Okay, so export to Procreate. Okay, when you export, make sure it's not JPEG. Make sure it's not PNG, SVG, or PDF, but Photoshop file. Then it can bring the layers over. And resolution, I think we just have 150 will do. Export to Procreate. Okay, I better remember to, when I go to Procreate, I better remember to turn on my record. Yeah, the monitor, so it can see what I do in Procreate. So now, yep, that's the file that we have exported. And see, when you export in as a Photoshop file, you can see all the different layers. What's the purpose of the layers? We can, as we mentioned about alpha lock, we can lock the layer, okay? And the reason of locking the layer, when you, let's say, select a brush, I'm now with the inking brush. Let's say if I select Inker 1, and I select a color, let's say yellow, and make it big, and I paint. You see? It doesn't spill over. Now look, if I select this one without alpha lock, I paint, it will come out. That is the reason of exporting the Illustrator file to Procreate as a Photoshop file. Then you can do your alpha lock. Let's undo that. Okay, now we're going to do alpha lock for 1, 2, 3, 4 more and show you the 4 different brushes. Okay, alpha lock. Okay, and then select your brush. So maybe I select artistic brush. I select this one. Select a color. Maybe I select a red. I paint. So if you can't really tell the difference, maybe you can put another color on top of it. Or white. Alright. And yeah. You can go back to put other colors, so it's like painting, yeah? Cool. Similarly, You can do that for the yellow later. So let's move on to the next one. Okay, alpha lock, tap alpha lock, select a color, maybe I select a blue or purple, and then select, now maybe I select a texture brush. Okay, maybe I want to have a certain texture like this. Look, so cool when I alpha lock it. Yeah, done. So that's the wonderful thing of exporting from Illustrator to Procreate with a Photoshop file, and then you can do the alpha lock. And later on, of course, we will merge them together and don't alpha lock so we can do the blending. But not for this lesson. I'm just going to show you the different brushes and how you can paint a bear with the different brushes and create a pop art style. So it's more a pop art style that I'm doing here. Okay, maybe a pink color for the body would be cool. Yeah, and select a brush. Okay, yeah, you can go back and select this another what you call texture brush and have a bigger dot, so and paint. Wow, okay. So if you think you want it bigger, so you max it, then you get a bigger dots. Yep. Yeah, and then finally we do one more. Alpha lock. Okay, what color should I use? Maybe I should use an orange. And select a brush. Okay, so maybe I can select an abstract brush. Okay. Let's try this. Okay, I'm quite happy that you can also put this abstract brush on this. So you have two different types of brush. Yeah. Yeah, so if you find that this is too bland, so you can actually fill in a color, then put the, and then you put the abstract or texture brush on it. So fill, very simple, just tap on the layer and put fill, whatever color they have. And then now maybe we select a white, and then a texture brush, okay. Okay, and paint. Yes, this looks better, right? Wait, I think I do it neater. Oh, so cool. So we got a nice panda bear. But how about the eyes, you may ask me. Okay, so the eyes, because we forgot to bring in the bear, so you have to go and import the bear. Just now I should import the bear together. Wait, sorry, back here. Add file. Okay, you will go right behind. You gotta bring it right behind. Okay, that's fine. So we just okay, tap the head where the eyes is. So all this, so we just make the opacity like the so it's not aligned. So we have to adjust our file. The bear. Yeah. So now roughly you can see the eye. Okay. Then we make sure you select this layer. Then we select a black color. Enlarge it. Oh, sorry. And select maybe an airbrush, not too big, not too small too, and paint. Oh, sorry, we should put a new layer so that it won't affect this layer. So we're doing a pop-up style so we can have it straight. Okay, enlarge it bigger. Oops, sorry. This is the basic of painting. Of course, there's a lot more you can do. I'm just showing you just some of the brushes and a simple pop art style drawing. And then we are done. Add some white. Okay, then we'll do the other black median airbrush. Okay, black. Okay, then we just close this. I can see. Oh, we forgot the nostril. Okay, and then the size. I think I know why the size was too small. Okay, and then put the opacity back. Yeah, this more like it. Okay, that's three. Okay.